here in the rock and roll studio with Jackknife Lee. Time to make the final cuts as the cream of the crop rises to the top. That's right, it's time to send our baby to the wolves. Rawr, rawr. Jackknife Lee.
Really is. We should do more often. Where, how did you record it?
Well, I didn't record it.
The people sending all the drums and everything?
Yeah. As different people wrote, they would usually re-record the track or parts of the track. Most of this version is performed by someone in Portland, Oregon.
Wow.
I did the lead vocal, of course.
It's pretty astonishing. It's a really good song. Really good song. Double chorus too. You know. Yeah. Which is great. I wasn't expecting that. And the bridge is wonderful.
Yeah.
The energy in it is fantastic. It doesn't let up at all. Sounds like a hit.
Yeah.
Wow. How long did that take to do?
It's 15 discrete steps over a period of 3 months or something. It's a pretty laborious process.
I would say it takes a long time, yeah. So you have to listen to that's an amazing amount of listening to begin.
Yeah, that's what it was.
And then keeping objective, because I'm sure, was all the standard pretty high, or?
Were my standards?
No, when people were sending in recordings.
Oh, no. Usually there's just a couple of ideas out of 30 or 40 that really rise above the rest, and choice is not too difficult.
And how are the lyrics done then? Did who came up with the idea?
The
initial idea.
Well, I don't have my list open, but you know, someone came up with a title. I first gave him the attitude I was looking for. Then somebody came up with the title. Then somebody else came up with the bulk of the lyrics.
Yeah. The songwriting credits are going to be interesting.
Yeah, it'll be quite long. I imagine at least 20 different writers.
Would you do it again?
I don't think I would do it again in this way.
Were these people who had written songs before, or generally, or within bands? And
well, I don't know for certain, but my impression is that some of these people are quite accomplished amateur musicians, and then some of them are just people who have never picked up an instrument before, but they have idea. Yeah.
It's really good, really good. And are you happy with the lyrics, all the lyrics?
I think most of it, yeah. There might be a few lines here or there that.
It's a big pop song.
Yeah.
You know, it's very joyous and celebratory, which is fresh, but could be lightweight at the same time.
Right.
Which is always a dangerous thing to play with.
Yeah.
But I think it's great. It's very hard to do joy well in a rock and roll song, because it can seem a little happy, I think, is the hardest thing to convey in a song. I think melancholy or rage is the language of part of the language of rock and roll. But happiness is really tough. I can't think of many songs that are successful at singing about happiness. But that's pretty good effort.
Yeah, I think we could probably do a few tweaks that would make it sound a little tougher. Or were you thinking a total rewrite of like completely new subject?
I don't know. I'll listen to it again and take it for a walk. it's, I mean, as it stands, it's great. I'm just wondering whether it would, if it was not about something, but had a something that I could take with me once the song was finished.
It's like a message.
It's. I mean, it's a pop song because it's about the moment, that particular moment that it exists for, and when the song ends, it's the end of the song.
Yeah.
Rather than say something that would, you know, stay in your mind and alter itself in there, which would make you want to hear it again, other than the jump up and down.
Yeah.
All of it.
It would have been tough unless it was like a real exceptional artist out there who could have written the lyrics.
Mm.
Yeah, it'd be tough to come up with that by committee.
Yeah, committee's always tough, but it doesn't sound like a committee song. You know, it doesn't sound that at all. So that was a big achievement. I really like it. Really like it.
Yeah, me too.
The quality of the recording is amazing too.
Yeah, this the guy who recorded this version is I think he's pretty good.
He's very good.
He's got a little home studio in Portland.
It'd be tough to beat it.
Well, I'm sure he'd give us any of these tracks if we want
to
use them.
That'd be great. We might have to. No, I think it's great. But yeah, I'd love to do something with it. Definitely. It goes onto the list. I'll go back. The secret list.
All right, so the drama continues. We're on the short list of 23 songs that needs to get cut down to 3.
What's it called? Turn It Up.
Turn It.
Turn It.
Very good.
Got to get it louder.
The extra surprise chorus is great.
Yeah.
But the bridge feels like another chorus again, which
yeah.
is great.
Hooks aplenty.
Yeah. No, that's great. I wasn't expecting that at all. I saw the first few Let's Write a Song, and then for some reason, I don't know, it was a UK thing, whatever, but I kept saying this video is no longer available on YouTube, so it was kind of annoying. But it's really transformed.
Okay, so should we go on to the next one?
Yes.